We're a big family. If something happens, we're there to support each other. We help each other out as much as we can, whether it's in our personal life or even dealing with a call here that's bothered us. We're there for each other.
It's like working with family, really.
We enjoy coming to work. It's not a place where we dread coming in every day.
You know, if you needed anything from anybody, we would call probably one of our coworkers sometimes before even our family members, because they are our family members.
One of the great benefits about being here is that it's a family atmosphere, not only in the center, but with your responders out in the community as well.
Automatically, I was welcomed with open arms. Everybody's so welcoming and friendly, and it's just a great place to work.
You don't go through anything by yourself, whether it be a personal incident or whether it be a work-related incident. You have your family here.
They're very good about teaching you everything you need to know.
Well, actually, our training program is actually one of our perks, because a lot of people our size don't have the ability to sit there and train somebody. They just kind of sit them down and do the job, whereas we're with you step by step. Let's do this. I'm going to get you through it.
Really let you pick what classes you want to take based on the career field you want to go down.
There's another training that I'm going to for stress related to the 911 center. It's for not only for me, but it's for our family members. Our spouses are allowed to go.
The interaction with other agencies at these classes provide kind of a look, you know, from another agency in as to some things that can change and be better.
Anytime we want to improve ourselves, they're definitely behind us to do that.
The city officials, the finance department, the chief financial officer, the city manager, the chief of police, who's my direct supervisor, and the commission, and anything that I say I need to better serve the citizens and the public and the responders of the community, they're completely on board and support us 110%.
But here we have very good equipment, the phone systems, the radios, they're very clear. We have good mapping.
Our equipment is actually brand new. It's only about, it'll be 3 years old. So we're all in new equipment. You know, we're stepping up the game. We're looking into our text 911, getting that started as well.
We're also looking at smart 911. It's a program where the citizens can actually go in and put in information based on their addresses, like medical information, key holder information, relatives, a more in-depth that will be right at our fingertips.
I became a 911 dispatcher due to my family being in a terrible car accident.
2 years ago, I went through a motorcycle wreck, and it was in this county.
I had five family members in the same car that were in the wreck. Two did not survive.
The responder was actually behind me and called it in over the radio, and it was two of my close friends that were in the dispatch center.
We were told if it was not for the quickness of response that we may have lost more family members.
When they transported me to the hospital, my director showed up, my assistant director showed up, some of the other dispatchers showed up. But not only that, the calls and the offering to help and if I needed anything was out of this world. I'd never experienced that in another career field that I'd ever been in.
And that led me in this direction, that I understood the importance of this job and what's required. And I wanted to be able to get in this career and provide the same help for anybody that called in.
It makes me proud, because I tell them every day, I wish I could give you all $1 million, because that's what you're worth to me. And that's what makes the center go round.